What's up everybody, it's LeakyTapsMan with another wishlist once again, and it is Gears of War 4 today. I know Gears of War 3 is not long gone, but we all know that sequels get made more or less as soon as the initial game has gone out, so I am more or less certain that there is another Gears of War in the works, so this is why I've done this video, to tell Epic Games what I would like. Firstly, and one of the main things that I think would be cool is a theatre mode, because Gears of War has like loads of epic stuff, and in multiplayer you often find yourself getting a really awesome kill and you often think, oh man, I really wish I was recording that, even if you've got a recording device, a capture card or something, and you just don't have it switched on and you think, oh man, I've missed a great opportunity there. Theatre mode would eliminate that. Something similar to Call of Duty even, where you can upload clips of under 30 seconds, I think it is. Something like that would really work in Gears, especially for the multiplayer, because there's a lot of OMG moments in that. Whether it could be done in single player or not, I do not know, but if Halo can do it, I assume Gears can. They're not really miles apart with their campaign structure. With the multiplayer in mind, I would say dedicated servers are an absolute must for everything, not just ranked games like in Gears 3. Epic finally caved in and actually got dedicated servers in Gears 3, which was great, and they were very good to play on. The lag was minimal. I'd just say add them to player matches as well, because not everyone likes to play ranked all the time. I don't really, and the ranked playlists are always much lower populated than the regular ones. Obviously it's going to be quite costly for Epic, but when you're making as much money as they do, especially when they are nickel and diming their customers no end, then they can afford it. Which actually leads me on to my next one. For the love of God, Epic, don't fleece us on the DLC. So don't charge us for maps that are on the disc already, because that is just, it's not right. And also this whole exclusive DLC for people that have gone to some fast food joint in America, I really can't remember, but basically all the green gun skins are exclusive to this one fast food chain, which is also another load of bullplop. I know it's only skins, but I always feel that all of the aspects of the game should be available to every player, regardless of whether you pay a bit extra or not, because we all paid for the game. All of that nastiness aside, I'll just say, for the campaign, make it a bit longer. Gears 3's campaign length was not bad compared to the first and second, but it could do with being a bit longer, especially when you've got four-player co-op in mind, because you can absolutely breeze through the game and get it done in a couple of hours, really, which isn't long enough in my opinion. I'd say for Horde mode, allow some really big ass maps that are only available in Horde, because as good as Horde is, I always feel it's limited by the size of the maps, because you have to use standard multiplayer ones, and when you're fighting against like Brumax and Reavers and really, really big enemies, I always think this needs to be on an epic map. Get it, epic? Ha ha. Yeah, it really needs to be on a big map to reach the full potential of Horde, I feel. But as far as features and fortifications and everything, they really went all out in Gears 3 with Horde mode, and I think not a lot needs to be changed on that side of things, literally just the maps. For Beast mode, again, not a great deal needs to be changed. I'd just say add a few more waves, because it always felt too short, and let us play as the bosses in some of the later waves, and let us fight against some really, really tough cogs. I think playing as like a Brumac or a Reaver again would really just be awesome, and allow for some pretty epic battles. Obviously if everyone on your team is a Brumac, then maybe you get a bit overpowered, but it's no more overpowered than what the Berserker is now, I guess. I'm sure they can balance it somehow, but Beast mode was really cool, just expand on that. And one gripe I had with Gears 3, more so than the first two, was the absolutely ridiculous requirements for the Seriously achievement. I don't know anyone that's going for this achievement, but if they do, then you're pretty much admitting that you just don't have a life. Seriously 1 and 2, while difficult, were very much achievable, but 3, where you have to literally play for months and months to get anywhere close to getting this achievement, I think it's absolutely insane that Epic can expect regular players to get the achievement. I know they had to one-up themselves from the last game, but scale it down a bit, I think, for Gears 4. In fact, I keep referring to it as Gears of War 4, but in terms of story, I think that a prequel would work well, because in Gears 1 we saw the whole emergence day thing. I think that could be done, or there's a lot of gaps in the story really in the three games, and I'm sure somewhere in between there is a really good story to be told, and the next Gears of War could capitalize on that. I'm going to admit I don't know a great deal about the Gears of War stories. I don't really play it for the story, I'll admit it, but I'm of the belief that Gears of War 3 had a pretty conclusive ending, so they would have to kind of go back in the timeline for it to make any kind of sense. We all thought Halo 3 had a pretty conclusive ending, and now we're getting Halo 4, so who knows. Another mode of play that I think would be really cool is another co-op kind of play, similar to Horde, I guess. If anyone's played Resistance 2, it's got this co-op mode with 8 players, where you kind of beast it through a level and you've got loads of boss type enemies and stuff, and everyone's got character classes, and it's really one of the best co-op experiences on any console this gen. I think that would really, really suit Gears of War, and I think that would be an awesome addition. Having class-based characters would obviously be a bit of a change from Gears, but the core concept of fighting these massive enemies in a giant group would really just be a really fun mode to play. Other than that, there's not a great deal. Obviously, add more of the same, so more mutators, new weapons and grenades, stuff like that. That's obviously a given. They could go down the Halo Reach route where they add a load of new weapons going back in a timeline and just call them prototypes, basically. And two quickies, daily and weekly challenges should be added for XP, and create a cog for multiplayer. Create your own guy, allow us to change the armor color and just basically start a guy from scratch instead of having to play as one of the predefined characters. And I think that's pretty much everything that Gears of War 4 needs to do. I mean, Gears of War 3 really refined a lot of things about Gears of War 1 and 2, but it didn't really wow anyone, and I think with all of those features, then Gears of War 4 can really regain some ground as a top series and a killer app for the Xbox. That's another thing. Release it on the Xbox 720 or the next Xbox, so the technology can really blow us away and you can actually add these kind of features without taking a hit on the graphics or the AI. And that's absolutely everything now that I would like in Gears of War 4. Tell me what you guys want. I'm a massive Gears fan, I absolutely love it. But I thought Gears of War 3 was not necessarily disappointing, but it didn't live up to my expectations. But they were sky high, to be fair. Thanks for all of your feedback in the others. Have a nice day, and please subscribe.